गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लास। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड डन द प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ द चैप्टर फोटोशॉप, इन विच वी हैव सीन द वर्क ऑफ डिफरेंट टूल्स विच वी वर यूजिंग फॉर द फॉर्मेटिंग ऑफ अ इमेज। सो नाउ वी हैव गॉट द न्यू चैप्टर Introduction to Flash. So, in this chapter, the topics which are going to be covered are Flash, starting Flash, how we will start the Flash, and a little introduction about Flash, how will you create a new Flash file in this, what were the components of the Flash window, then set up a new flash stage, layers on which we are working, animation in flash, how the animation takes place in flash, adding frames, creating frame by frame animation, okay, creating twin and saving the flash file. These all topics will be covered in this chapters, okay, in this chapter, not the chapters, okay, by mistake it is spoken. So now, without wasting time, we are coming to the topic Flash. What happens in this beta? In this, you will see that Flash is a multimedia software specially designed for creating vector graphics. Okay. Remember this, vector graphics, animations, games, web page components. So this is a multimedia software which is used to design, create the graphics, animation, games and web page components. Flash is also used for making a video over the internet. So this is also a good feature in Flash. In Flash, you can insert an image and add animation to that image. When you run that function, it is playing a movie. Like as you have seen, many other softwares are also coming in which you are just inserting your picture and adjusting them, framing them, and when you play that picture, it looks like they are playing a movie. The Flash Player plugin allow users to view Flash in their browsers. Nearly all current web browsers support Flash. Means now the browsers which are coming, the current latest one, they are also supporting the Flash. So this is a small introduction of Flash. Now we are coming on a next topic, features of Flash. What are the features of Flash? First one, create illustration and other artwork. Okay, it creates the illustration, means example, and other artwork. Flash has many drawing tools that allow you to create vector graphics. Okay, now I'm going to tell you what is a vector graphic. See, what are vector graphic? Vector graphic actually are the computer graphic images that are defined in terms of points on Cartesian plane, which are connected by lines and curves to form a polygon and other shapes. Okay, these are vector graphics. Okay, as you remember it, okay, here the dots are given or the lines are given and you are joining them and creating a figure. Okay, so that is your vector graphic. Are composed of lines, curves and polygons. So it is given over here also. Conversely, if you see, bitmaps are made up of pixels. The main benefit of using vector graphic in Flash object or project is that they are smaller in size and these graphics can downloaded at a very fast speed over the internet. Okay, so if you create a graphic, it will be easily and fastly downloaded from the internet. So that's why This is a feature of Flash which the people were using. Now next, work with symbols and instances. Symbol are objects in Flash that you can reuse. Okay, symbols are the objects in Flash. You can draw, erase, add or remove instances on one layer without affecting another layer. As you can see, the layers were there in Photoshop also. If you are working on first photo, that shows the first layer. Then you come to the second photo, it starts a second layer. Then you come to the third layer, it starts a third layer. Okay, if you do any changes in the first layer, that does not affect the second or third layer. Okay, so that's why it is said that symbols are objects in Flash that you can reuse. These objects can be graphics, buttons, movie clips, sounds and videos. These we can be reused. Copies of symbols that are used in Flash movie is called instances. Okay, so the copies of symbols which are used in a Flash are called instances. Now create animation. There are many ways to animate in Flash. You can create animation by using a frame by frame or motion twinned method. So two methods are there, motion twinned, or you can create with frame by frame. So here you have seen, you can draw, erase, add, remove instances one layer without affecting the another layer. You can also hide layer and lock layers. You can also use layers for organization in a more complex Flash discount, and they were very helpful in working with multiple animations. Okay, so remember this thing, that you can also use the layers for organization in a more complex Flash document, and they were very helpful in working with multiple animations. Now next topic is, okay, there are some parts also released. There are two main types of Flash files you can use to create a Flash movies. First one is .fla and second one is ActionScript. .as, ActionScript files. Flash documents are the base file type you use to create a Flash movies. Flash organized with an application SmartTek developed by Jonathan Gay. Gay was the co-founder of Future Wave Software in 1993. So presently, Flash developed and distributed by Adobe and popularly known as Adobe Flash. So these update your knowledge are also important as regarding your examinations. Okay, so tell this, you have heard about Flash. Now how will you start Flash? So starting the Flash, the process is, click on start button to open start menu. A list of installed apps appears on the screen. Yes, then scroll down and click on add a Flash professional CC. Flash Professional CC opens with a welcome screen in front of you. I think I don't have Flash CC, that's why it is not opening. I will hope if I find out from somewhere, I will show you. Now creating a new Flash file. Flash files are called documents or movies. Flash file are called documents or movies. You can create a new document in Flash to design artwork or create an animation. Okay, so remember this one, Flash file also called documents or movies, and you can create new document in Flash, design artwork or create animation. So first what you do, click on file, then the file menu appears, click on new. You can also press Ctrl N as a shortcut from the keyboard. You can also press Ctrl N as shortcut keys from the keyboard. The new document dialog box appears. Then next, click on the document type you want to create. If example you will take, we have selected ActionScript 3.0 from here, the arrow. Okay, so a description of each type appears in this area, in this box you can see here. So click on OK. A blank document appears in the flash. So if you see over here, you will see that flash is used for making advertisement and games. Mostly you have seen that it is an animated part because it's a multimedia program. So it is used for making advertisement and games, and there are various websites available where flash games are available free to play online. So now some of the sites name is given over here: www.friv.com, www.novelgames.com and www.flashgame.net. These are the website where you can get online games to play made on flash. Now let's see what are the components of flash given in this. So see, here's the window comes. The flash program window has a number of components with which you must familiarize yourself before working with graphic and movies. Okay, so let's see what are the things in this window. So as usual, first menu bar, then title bar, under that file name tab, and current scene. See here it is given current scene, okay, the arrow symbolizes. Then here properties tab, workspace menu, then library tab, we will get all the things, the library, tools panel, different tools are provided over here, stage where you will work, frame by framework, frame number is given, layers, different layers you will see over here, timeline again, and timeline button. Okay, these all things are over here. Let's see what are these. So next, title bar. As usual, the same definition. Title bar displays the name of the open file and allow you to open, close and minimize flash window. Okay, next one is menu bar. Menu bar is a special toolbar that displays the flash menu names. Okay, so menu bar is always, it's a special toolbar that displays the menus of different windows also, so in flash also. File name tab, this tab shows the name of the current file on which you are working. If two or more files are open, you can switch from one file to the other by clicking a tab. Okay, if you have opened more than one file, then what you can do, you can switch from one file to the other. Tools panel, it has the basic tools for creating and working with vector graphics. Okay, so for vector graphic you are having the tools panel. Current scene, it shows the name of the scene on which you are currently working. Okay, working on some scene, so it will show the name of the scene on which we are working. Now we comes to the stage area. In this area is also known as flash editor. A movie over graphic displays, the white one you have seen just now. Stage, work area, the area surrounding the stage is called work area. Anything placed on this area does not appear in the movie. That means the stage, the center you have seen, which, okay, see the stage, the white portion, it is surrounded by the work area. Okay, so anything placed on this area does not appear in the movie. Now library tab, it is used to organize and select symbols to add to your movie. Whatever symbols are there, it will select and add to our movie. This is the work of the library tab. Now property tab, it is used to view and edit
properties of the current object. Okay, whatever the properties were there, it will show the current object's properties. Workspace menu, it allowed you to switch between workspaces and create a new ones. Okay, when you create a new one, it will allow you to switch from workspace to new. Okay, timeline, it is used to design the timing for the sequence of the movies. In this part, frame are highlighted that you can choose for playing the movie. Whatever frame you choose for the movie, it will be selected. Okay, and the sequence of the movies will be done with the help of timeline. It will show on the timeline. Layer, it enable you to keep pieces of artwork separate and combine them to form a merged image. Okay, layers enable us to keep piece of artwork separate and combine them to form a merged image, such as company logo that includes a layer of text and another layer with a graphic shape. Means here is a logo in which a text is written in this box. So we will have this layer different and this layer different. This layer will consist of text, and this if there is a graphic, then another layer will have a graphic. Okay, so the different layers are there and we are working. If you select the layer second layer, you will work on second. If you select fourth layer, then you work on fourth layer. Timeline button, scattered around the timeline are the buttons for controlling frames, layers and movies. These are used to control the frames, movies, layers. Now frame, what is frame? The length of time in a flash movie are divided into frames. They enable you to control what appears in animation sequence and which sounds play. Okay, so frame by frame work is there. Okay, so the movie is divided into frames. You see the movie, so you don't think that oh, it is continuously it is moving, but now there are frames which are merged together and they have played like this that you don't see the frames. Okay, so it's all done by the flash. Now frame number, frame appear in a chronological order in the timeline and each frame has a number. So the sequence of the number is selected and kept. Okay, so this is frame number. So I hope you have all got the information about the window, means the components of the flash window. Now understanding the flash timeline. Okay, see, like Photoshop you have done, in this also you have to remember all the things and concentrate on this. Okay, because now the chapters are totally different from the previous classes. You have to keep your mindset for these. It's not like that you have read and done the question answers. If you want to learn something, then of course you have to focus on this. The flash timeline contains the frames, layers and scene that make up a movie. Okay, so what are the three things you have seen? First the frame, second the layer, and third the scene that make up a movie. You can use the timeline to organize and control your movies. Layers are representation of depth in space, while frames are representation of time. Okay, so these layers are the depth representation space, but frames are the representation of time, and frames can be used for building animation over time. Okay, now see the current space, it is displaying the name of the scene on which you are currently working. Now layers, see here layers are made, layers to organize artwork, animation, sound, interactive elements. Layers enable you to keep pieces of artwork separate and combined and them to form a merged image. Means the artwork are separate and it combines them to form a merged image, such as a company logo that includes a layer of text and a layer of graphic shape. Okay, now on timeline button, here you can see the timeline button. Scattered around the timeline are buttons for controlling frames, layers and movies.